Ava was just chatting with a with an African this morning, right before I got to her. And again, it's going back and forth. And again, I see what's going on. We see what's going on, the God idea. So I have, you know, brought this up in many ways in the groups. And the last one that I wrote, I keep updating these things, you might say. The last one I wrote is Visit Your God. Okay, so it's, you know, I'm being nicer, you might say, to these people because, yes, they have their gods, and that's fine. You know, the gods are there. They are. The gods are not really gods. It's just that this is what people have decided they are, you know, so like movie stars. You know, they've been marketed. They can take anybody, doesn't matter, you know, and make them supposedly exceptional because they can dance and sing, or they can, you know, act a particular way, or they're nice looking, or whatever it is, whatever ideas or attributes they use. And they market them, and they get agreement from the public. And so all of a sudden, they're called movie stars. And to many people, the movie stars, like Elvis Presley and many other people, they're gods too, you see. Again, so are they bigger than life? That's an old saying, isn't it? Oh, gee, you know, you're bigger than life, or this person or that person. And so, you know, these are ideas that people make realities. And so, yes, I've always said when people talk about that, because that's a biggie, I've always agreed with it. You know, usually I say I'm fine with everything, because I am. Everything's fine. Everything has its place, and it's workable. Or you just let people do what they do. And so, it's like life itself. Can you just explain it in a sentence, a paragraph, or even in books and volumes? No, you can't, because even when you do, it's not that at all. It's really what you cannot consider, all right? So it's interesting to notice people come into this. The reality of the isness is exceptional because it's complete, pure, and real, and sincere, and many things that are just a total benefit. That's really what it is. But it's like in the movie Hook, where they're sitting down for dinner, and you have to learn to see it. You see, you have to learn to see it. And again, it's like the relationship between two people. You know, if they decide to love each other, that's a decision and an agreement. Well, you have to see it. You see, it's not only about the body, but it's really about you know, what is unseen. And so, this is what's unique about us, and this is what I bring forward. Again, we're not common. The things that are created are common, which is fine, and they are a reference to the true reality. But again, people have to learn to see that. And if they don't, they don't. You know, it's like a mother telling her children stories. You know, if the child is just sitting there and it's like, well, Mom, that's a boring story. I don't know. You know, I don't get it. It's like, okay, that's because the child has not seen it. But some children listen and they go, oh, you know, because see, they're imagining as a first step. Because imagination is just in creation. It can touch reality. It can be a connection. But it is not reality itself. There is a difference. Because in the real universe, you don't need imagination. Why would you need imagination when everything is complete? You see, in creation, we use imagination, this is the best part, because it weaves its way through anything and it can produce anything. Where the mind is a routine, there is a difference. And the emotions are simply reaction. The physical body is basically a dud. That's just what it is. It's just a body, okay, like your car. Okay, it just sits there until you activate it. So the biggie here, Charles, is the God idea. Always, of course, it always is framed around that, if it's religion, belief, whatever. And we see, and this again is the challenge. So as I look at the world, I'm always looking at the activity of the world, which is basically nuts. Okay, people are more than happy to, you know, poison and destroy themselves. That's where they start their car every day and just drive off and, you know, listen to the radio, turn it up full blast, and, you know, they just don't consider anything. You know, they just don't see what they're doing. But it's whatever. You know, this is how it is. But everything that is taking place in the world mainly is, you know, the reptilians have gotten people to agree to all this stuff. That's really what it is. And all we can do is present something that makes sense. And many people are seeing this, but at the same time, they have a fear factor. So nobody's under obligation here. We're not under obligation for people to see what we're presenting. And they're not under obligation or with any obligation to recognize what we're presenting. So everything's fine. And so we're on our adventure. It's like what I'm doing with basically Ava and Valen, because they're very close, and that is, and then with all of you, is just to just keep doing, you see, and just keep presenting. And each person, again, like you in school with the students, you know, they can sit there and ask about the lesson all day long, but until they do it, until they do their homework or whatever, you see, but it's that stepping up. And it's like a person that wants to play baseball. It's very simple. Okay. You're going to go out there and you're going to swing a lot. You're going to miss the ball. What are you going to do? Say, oh, gee, I can't hit the ball, so I don't want to play. Well, you got to keep doing it until you figure it out. You know, it took me almost 2 years to figure out my writing. And I did that for 8 and 10 hours a day. I hammered it. So it's a big challenge here. The world basically is so routined in their own demise, and they can't see it. And so all we can do is present it and deal with it as it comes along, but not be concerned about who steps up or whatever. So it's the doing part. It's simply doing. That's what the boys do. They simply do. And it's once you get the basic idea, it's like you showing up in the classroom every day. You just do what you do, and you see the students in the class. But you really don't have to consider a whole lot. You know, you consider certain things, but, you know, you have to keep doing what you're doing. And certain students will do their homework. And so you can't be overly concerned with that, because you're not obligated for them to do what they should decide to do for themselves. And that's each person. You know, the unique thing about us in our position here is that I watch people as they come in, you might say. And I see if they will step up and do something. In other words, decide to support those who will support them. That's very, very real. This is not something like where you have the master and the students and whatever, and you have followers and all this nonsense. This is what people think. It's not that at all. You know, you decide, each individual decides to step up and shine like the sun. That's all. It's just very simple. And then we're all sons. We all shine. And we simply contribute and do our part, and we support each other. You see, it becomes a unique position to recognize, and we share this. So the idea as we come to the Skypes is to bring something to share. Not to come and it's like, oh, I don't know what to do. You know, again, we've all lived actually millions of lifetimes. And through all that experience, we've gained certain ideas and objectives, etc., to eventually come to the point where we start to recognize this isness, because it's so huge. And now you're starting to walk into an endless, endless area. So with what is going on the Earth, it is really very minute. It's really very teeny tiny. And now that you know about the isness and it's up to you, you might say, to figure it out, consider it, and mainly see it, and from there present something that makes sense, that can relate to this reality so others can benefit, and you can benefit too. That becomes your journey. So it only makes sense, doesn't it? Life does make sense, and we're making sense of it. So it's not about what the world is doing. I don't consider what the world is doing. The world can do whatever it wants. It can blow itself up, whatever, which it's doing. It's doing it very well. It's actually very good at it. I can't stop it. It's fine. All I can do really is present what I do, keep doing and doing and doing, see who shows up, and from those individuals, you know, I take the time to kind of coordinate them into what makes sense. But they're going to have to decide. They're going to have to be motivated in their own ways, just like a person that wants to teach school like you have. You were motivated to go through all the courses that you did to become the teacher. And so it's the same with this. And so when people come up with all these questions, which is fine, I suggest, look, read the books, do something, set out this idea just like you would take a course in college. The teacher is not going to explain the whole course in the first 15 minutes when people ask. You're just going to have to go through the course to see if the course is for you. And even if it's not for you, you still gain something if you could see from that. I gain something from everything. So, the challenge is huge there. And Africa and all the other countries, nothing here is different. It's like Paul used to say, all emotion is the same. It really is. It's just how you see it. And so as we look at the world, it appears as though everything's different. But really, it's all the same in creation. It is something created. And it is something necessary to recognize this isness. And this recognition is ongoing once you truly do recognize it and see it. This is what's so cool, and it supersedes creation altogether. And yet at the same time, you still have creation. Again, nothing is negated. You learn to kind of blend it all. You learn to kind of, have everything in its place, just like in your house. Just because you get a new couch, that doesn't mean you throw the rest of the furniture out. Not at all. You just add to the house. Now we got a new couch, and it goes with the dinette set, and it goes with the pictures on the wall. Whatever, see? You're redecorating. That's all. You're bringing something in. And so I understand this is how the world sees it, too. They're in many ways seeing the new presentation, something like, religion versus the new presentation. Well, it's not that. It's not that at all. Because life is an isness. It's already complete. And it's nothing new, even though it is always new. But it has always been. This is the best thing, you see? And so, again, people have been, basically brainwashed with the idea that, there was a beginning and an ending of things and whatever. Does that make sense? When something that is always is. And so, again, to grasp that, that's huge. So a step at a time. So, again, it's the challenge. It is your challenge, too, to bring this forward for you to wake up. That's it. Not just because you have the information that I've created, the reference. It's really reference. That's all it is. It's only reference. And again, many people think that, well, I know this, or I've read the books or whatever. Well, that's, until you recognize the is and you demonstrate and you step up and do as the boys do, as the real guides do, take your position and support those that will support you, you're really not there yet. You need to do this. You need to figure that out. Just like if you want to be part of the baseball team, you need to figure it out how you're going to be one of the players. And until you do, you're not. That's just really how it is. This is how we play the game here. So once you step up and do that, and so it's really a very simple thing, but then again, because of how people have been educated here, purposely dumbed down and one-dimensionalized by the systems to be controlled, yeah, they have a huge struggle. The challenge is with themselves. You know, the challenge is not with the new presentation and the references that I give. You know, you need to point them back to themselves, and that is that the challenge is with themselves. They must decide if they want to see it to where it makes sense. We'll be right back.